Hello students, in this tutorial we will see how to implement SOAP-based web service in Java by using Apache Tomcat server in the Eclipse IDE. In my last tutorial video, I have explained how to install Apache Tomcat server in the Eclipse IDE. Link of that video is mentioned in the description box. First of all, understand what is web services. Web services basically are nothing but the services that can be used or accessed over the network. With the help of web services, two devices or two different applications can communicate with each other. By using web services, we can create or we can imagine a software system that allows us to have communication between two different machines or two different applications. That means it allows us to have interoperable communication. These web services consist of various different standards and list of protocols that are used to exchange information between the devices or applications. Let us consider this figure. Total 6 boxes are there. Imagine these boxes are nothing but the applications. All these applications are connected to each other by means of a web service. So these applications can communicate or can exchange the data among themselves with the help of web services. For an example, let us consider the application money control uses the data from National Stock Exchange Board and Bombay Stock Exchange Board. That means in the money control application, we can get or we can fetch the stock market data available at NSE and BSE websites. This is nothing but the NSE website where all stock exchange related information or stock market prices are listed. Similarly, we can have BSE website or BSE web application where all Bombay Stock Exchange stock market prices are listed. From these two applications, the data is fetched on money control app. So this money control app holds some web services that will fetch the data from NSE site as well as from BSE site. The implementation stack of money control need not to consider the implementation stack of BSE as well as NSE. That means these applications can communicate with each other without considering on which technology or on which platform they are built. So web services are primarily can be imagined, can be viewed in such type of applications. Considering this fact, we can differentiate between web application and web services. Web application are nothing but the information that can be accessed by the users within a browser, whereas web services are nothing but the information shared by or used by two different applications. Now the intention behind that can be access the data or perform some transaction. In the web application, we have information in the human readable format, whereas in the web services, the specialized formats are used such as XML or JSON. Web application always transmit or exchange the data with the help of HTTP or HTTPS protocol, wherein in the web services, two standard protocols are used. One is SOAP protocol for the SOAP based web services, and second, HTTP or HTTPS for RESTful type of web services. Web applications do not have any component that can be reusable again and again. That means web application has some unique functionality, wherein in the web services, the components of it can be reusable. For an example, if I have login web service, such type of web service can be applicable or can be deployable for any kind of web application where the authentication and authorization is the main functionality. Web application can access the other web services to access the data or to perform some transaction, but web services are not allowed to access the web application. Instead, it forms an API for application 1 as well as application 2. With the web application, we are able to store or we are able to hold the user session, whereas web services are totally stateless. That means their state or their session cannot be kept. There are basically two types of web services. Number one, it is SOAP, and second, it is RESTful web services. The SOAP web service stands for Simple Object Access Protocol. It is typically based on XML based standard protocol, which is used for designing and developing the web service applications. As it is based on XML, it is platform as well as language independent, because XML is adapted by any type of language. So the server based on Java can able to communicate with the client that is installed or that is developed with the help of .NET technology stack or PHP. In the REST type of web services, first of all, what is REST? REST is representational state transfer. It is an architectural style for developing the web service. That means some constraints are already put for the development of web service. It is not a protocol, it provides you the architecture style. The REST type of web services are widely used as compared to SOAP just because they are very much easy to develop. The REST web services having the components that can be identified with the help of their uniform resource identifiers. With Java, there are typical naming convention to identify SOAP and the REST web service. The Java based SOAP web service, it is named as JAX-WS, whereas the Java based REST type of web service, it is denoted as JAX-RS. In the JAX-WS, we have Java APIs for XML based web services. So we will have the implementation and deployment of web services based on the XML standard. Whereas in the RESTful type of web services based on Java, we have Java APIs to implement such type of web services. In the RESTful web services, the major use of annotation is there that simplifies the development and deployment of such web service applications. In the next tutorial, we will see how we can create a simple web service by using Eclipse and Apache Tomcat. I will just introduce you what kind of application we are going to implement. We are going to implement a SOAP based web services where for the any country, we will identify who is the captain of its cricketing team. So please visit my next tutorial as well, where we will have implementation of this type of web service. Thank you so much.